So let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we lift you up here today. Thank you for this wonderful day. We thank you for the lives of these graduates. Thank you for everything you have done in their lives. Thank you that you have protected them, that you have educated them, and we pray that you keep on doing so. We thank you that you have blessed their lives and pray that they continue to bless their lives and the lives of their families. We pray for their prosperity. Bless this day, this graduation ceremony, and the rest of the day, the parties. Bless friends and family that are here visiting. We pray for safe travels and for joy, peace, and happiness, and that you, Lord, is glorified. We pray this in your holy name. Amen.
For those of you that don't know, that is Mr. Martin Ask, and he is Malva's father. They have joined us here for the year from Sweden, so it's great to have them with us. I just wanted to start our session here with a little bit of some opening remarks. First of all, just to say welcome to all our families and our friends, our graduates and the faculty and the staff. Welcome to the graduation ceremonies for the class of 22. It's amazing. So let's give them a hand. Yeah. There was a professional athlete who once said, if you live for the applause, then you place your happiness in the hands of the audience. And I thought, you know, for a guy who's playing professional sports, that's a wise statement. You know, we know that graduation is not an end, but it's really just the beginning, right? This is the opportunity that they have to use everything that's been invested in them, both at home, and I want to emphasize that at home, there has been so much invested in them. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank every parent here for your tireless efforts, your prayer, the way that you stood by your children, that you invested in their lives and taught them what was right and taught them to swallow sometimes when they didn't feel like it, for the glory of God. And you have turned a bunch of characters into students with character. Really, they are amazing young people, and we're very blessed by that. What do we do with those opportunities that have been invested in us, seniors? I mean, this is it, right? This is it. You have the opportunity right now in front of you to take everything that's been invested into your life and either forget about it, forge out a new plan, or to use it as a foundation so that when you do forge out, you are ready to go with a foundation of truth that will keep you. How will your parents be evaluated? Did they set you up for the best success in this life? You know, that's a real temptation, and that's part of it. We want to prepare you for the next steps in your life. But I think most importantly, our parents here made a choice to put you in a school that didn't just have academics, but that had spiritual aspect, right? That there was a growth in your life that was going to set you up for the next years of your life. And we like to say that graduation's not today, but it's for the next 5 and 10 and 15 years of your life. So I want to, again, commend our parents. Thank you for doing something that's going to last in their lives. Yes, academically. And there are some really bright students here. You'll hear about it in a little while when we talk about our honors. But there's some really bright students here. And even beyond grades, there are some students that have character and who are going to be incredible influencers of their generation. And that doesn't happen without our families. So thank you, families. Thank you for your tireless efforts. And just to wrap this part up, the preparation for life started in your life with your families investing Christ in you. It continued in Sunday school and in youth ministry and in elementary and middle and high school. You had something invested of you, in you. And that Philippians 1:6, that we can be confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in us, right? He has begun the good work in us. And that work will continue until the day of Jesus Christ, right? He will continue in us. And the last thing for you seniors, there's going to be a lot to think about from here on out, right? A lot vying for your attention. And I just want to remind you of one thought from Philippians 4. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which you have both learned and received and heard and seen in him, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. The applaud of people is pale in comparison to the peace of God. So today, well done. Thank you for being here. But embrace the things of God and watch the peace of God go with you wherever you go. Okay, God bless you. Right now, we'd like to have our seniors come up and we have our senior song. So those that are involved in that.
Show me your face. Fill up this space. My world needs you right now. My world needs you.
Okay, so we don't have such a great school unless we have a great vision. And we don't have a great vision unless there are people to promote that vision and uphold that vision. And we're privileged to be able to have our pastor here who has been our biggest cheerleader. He's been also in the school teaching these seniors. They have a class with him weekly, which has been amazing, a leadership class. And we get to hear him give our commencement address. So let's welcome Pastor Tom Schaller.
Well, congratulations to the senior class and to the staff and the parents. You did a great job. To the staff, I wrote out a couple things here just to mention. Here they are. Maybe just you want to stand up if you've been an administrator or youth leader or teacher here in our school at GGCA. I think they recognize, yeah, there they are. Very good. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Julius just played the piano, and where is he? Julius, okay. You want to yell out that quote that you mentioned just before? All right, go ahead, give it a try. All right, so the intellectuals in our country value what is new more than they value what is true. All right, is that true, that sentence? I want you to think about it for a minute. It got my attention a few minutes ago when I heard him say it, and it relates a bit to what we want to say today. Do people in our culture value what is new more than what is true? So turn to your neighbor and ask them what they think about that. Okay, great. Secondly, Plato, the philosopher Plato, wrote a paper called The Republic, and in it he kind of describes society and the kind of people that make up a society. And he said there are three parts to the body of a man. There is the head, the brain, the chest, and then the legs. And he said there are three kinds of people in society. The head, the intellectuals, the chest is the military that takes courage, and then the legs are the farmers that are farming in the fields and working the common labor jobs. European society was based on this idea. Feudalism. In the castle, you had the intellectuals and the military that are protecting the peasants that would go out in the society, out in the fields, and they would work. And C.S. Lewis took this idea and he wrote a paper, an essay called Men, Men That Do Not Have Chess. Education that does not give people courage. You can look that essay up and read it. It's interesting. And I like to think about Christ coming into our life and giving us a mind that we can think. And we are not following what is new. We are following what is true. What a good idea. Christ said, the truth will set you free. But we have not only a head, we have also a heart. And I was thinking of our staff here, because our school and to the graduates, no matter what school you go to in the future, I think you will always remember that this school has a heart. Because these teachers have heart. They care about you. They could talk to you as a teacher and as a friend. The coach would coach you not only to know how to play basketball or play soccer, but to have courage in the game, to have your heart in the game. So this is a Christian school. And in our culture today, I see how crazy people are thinking about new things. How crazy they are about new things. But how foolish we can be following things that are new, untested, unproved. But Christ came into the world to give us a true education. Not only we would be able to discern the spirit and understand what is said, but we were able to take it. There's a Greek word for it. It's a word for prudence. It's translated prudence. It means that you know where a thing is going. If you drink alcohol, you can kind of get an idea of where things may go, how bad it can be. Every year, graduating time, we read about somebody who was killed at a party or drowned in a lake or the river, or somebody was shot or stabbed, car accidents, and so on. We have an education of the mind and also of the heart, and also we are hard workers. We learn this. We learn to apply ourselves. So in 2 Timothy chapter 3, Paul said this to Timothy, and I'll finish in a minute, when he writes about the end times and says they are perilous times in verse 1, and then it describes our culture. Men will be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. And the list goes on. Bad news. Now comes the good news. Here it is, verse 10. But you have fully known my doctrine. I was with a relative one time, and I used the word dogma, and they were in shock. Dogma? They were like in shock, like dogma. Yes, dogma. Black and white, 2 + 2 = 4, it is not 5. Physics, mathematics, history, truth versus error, let's tell some lies. Napoleon Bonaparte was Chinese. No, he wasn't. That's ridiculous. He was French. No, I want him to be Chinese. So in my world, he's Chinese. Well, we can live in a lie, but we'll suffer by being liars. We can make our world to be what we want it to be, but we will suffer. I want to find somebody that I can follow. And it says here, Paul said to Timothy, you have fully known my doctrine, my manner of life, my purpose, my faith, my long-suffering, my charity, my patience, persecutions, afflictions. Another way of saying it, you have known who I am as a full man. You know my heart, you know my head, my understanding, you know my courage, you know my suffering, you know how I live and how I work. This is a great education. And I want to say to the parents, congratulate you for caring about your children. And the good news is you've done a great job. You sent them to an excellent school where we are serious about educating them in a full-orbed way, where we care about their future, their spiritual life, their understanding, and they're on the road, and it's their decision. But you've cared. The bad news is it's not over. They're 18 years old, and they need you till they're 22 and 24. They still need mom and dad. They still need friends, godly friends. They're still on the course. They're still figuring it out. They still got to find what it will be their education, what will be their calling, what will be their career. And we care about them as much as we can. So the last part here is, Paul said to Timothy, he said, but continue in the things which you have learned. When you find Christ, you continue in him. You keep your heart right before God, and you ask him to fill you. There's nobody great in this room. Nobody, none of us have any advantage over anybody else. We all are weak, frail people, but we have found him, and we care about him, and we continue in what we have learned and we are assured of, knowing of whom you have learned them, and that from a child you have known the scriptures, which are able to make you wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. And scripture, here it is. Scripture is given by the inspiration of God. It will speak to you. It will comfort you. It will counsel you. I have four children. They all have different kinds of educational profiles. They all have different things in life, and they were all brought up in our family. And it was always, you know, no matter where you are and what you find yourself doing in life, it is God that will help you. It is God that will answer your prayer. It's God that will guide and lead you. It's God that will open your heart and your mind and make you fruitful and useful in life so that you can be a servant. You discover and learn what it is to be a servant. One last thing. In one of our classes, I asked the high school to come up with a marker and draw a picture of the country that their mom or dad is from. Where their mom or dad is from. So we had, and then say something in the language of the country. And I realized, because Greater Grace is a missionary church, that we've had missionaries in these countries, Finland and India and other places, and France and that these young people have that in their background, at least 10 of them. At the end of the class, we had Russia on the, you know, a mark, you know, did it look like Russia? We had Finland and France and Greece, and we had 10 countries, 10 different languages, because their moms or dads are from these places. And most importantly is that the moms and dads have found Christ and want their children to follow him and know him. But we cannot put it in them. I mean, we cannot make anybody be a believer, but we can labor. And we can say, like Paul said to Timothy, continue. Continue in the things that you've heard. Continue in the things that you have learned. Continue to trust in God, and he will show you. He is a good God. He is the only wise God. He is a living God. So to the staff, I believe you guys did an awesome job. I believe you poured your heart into it. I believe you stayed up at night. I believe you prayed for these people. To the parents, congratulations. And we're so thankful for the end result here. And to the students, continue. Amen.
Okay, congratulations to the graduates and to their families and all of the sacrifices that have been made. And at this time in our program, we're going to give out two very important awards. As the program continues, there will be academic awards, of course, athletic awards. But these next two awards that we give out are very important because they really are the essence of the education that our young people have received here. They're the Christian Character Award and the Christian Leadership Awards. And you know, sometimes when you take that word Christian, you know, it's used so often today, you just put it in front of something else and it seems to describe it as being Christian. Like, right, a Christian music, right? You know, a Christian society. I mean, you can just, does it have any meaning anymore? What does it actually mean? These awards mean a lot because you can almost substitute the word Christian in the Leadership Award, Character Award, and put Christ-like because that's what they are. And all of these students, all of our graduates have demonstrated Christian character and Christian leadership to some degree and to some measure. But these two individuals that we're about to give these awards to are very, very important. The first one is the Christian Character Award, if we could have that. And the recipient of this Christian Character Award, a Christ-like character award, is given to an individual. And it's for exemplary Christian character awarded on behalf of the administration, faculty, and students of the Greater Grace Christian Academy on this 21st day of May, 2022. And this individual exemplifies this kind of Christ-like character in the classroom, on the field of play, outside of school, and we know and believe and trust that she will continue to do that whatever her path, wherever her path may take her. I think she's going to university, so that's very encouraging. But please welcome the 2022 Christian Character Award winner, Sharina Moradova. As Pastor Barry said, you know, they came into the school as a bunch of characters, and now they leave with Christian character. It's amazing. Praise God. Okay, next, the Christian Leadership Award. And this individual really has exemplified what Christian leadership or Christ-like leadership is all about in so many different ways. He has done it on the stage. He has done it on the field of play. He has done it throughout our church and ministry. And we're very, very pleased to be able to honor him today and to recognize this individual for his exemplary Christian leadership qualities, awarded on behalf of the administration, faculty, and students of the Greater Grace Christian Academy on this 21st day of May, 2022. And this year's 2022 Christian Leadership Award is presented to Nicholas Yuri Wyman.
We have an amazing, amazing batch of seniors this year. And this is demonstrated partly by the fact that they've been honored with record amounts of acceptance into other colleges, tremendous monetary scholarships to attend universities like Loyola, Drexel, University of Delaware, and others. In addition, many of them are continuing on with MBCNS in the fall. And regardless of where they end up, we're just excited that they've demonstrated that wherever God leads them, they'll follow in ways that we can't imagine. So at this time, I have the privilege of presenting to you the 2022 graduates who have earned honors and high honors over the four years in their high school. First, we're going to present the graduates who are graduating with honors. Honors are awarded to those who have a cumulative grade point average of 3.50 up to 3.74 over their 4 years of high school. And we're real proud of these students as they have worked diligently to achieve this status of graduate with honors. Will the following please stand and face the congregation? Lydie Noble. Malva Ask. Junghyun Shin. Excellent. We would now like to present the graduates who are graduating with high honors. High honors are awarded to students who have a cumulative grade point average of 3.75 and above over their 4 years of high school. We're extremely proud of these students as they worked most diligently to achieve this status of graduate with high honors. Will the following please stand and face the congregation? Austin Mary. Evan Arsenal. Nicholas Wyman. True McCullough. Ryan Horton. Yana Andrews. Lydia Bridges. And Sharina Muradova. Let's all give these awesome students a round of applause.
So I have the opportunity to introduce first the salutatorian and the valedictorian. So it's my first honor is to introduce the class of 22 salutatorian. This student has achieved the second highest grade point average in this graduating class over their 4 years of high school. The final result of tabling for the winner was very, very, very close. And this person worked diligently all the way to the finish line, achieving a 3.989 grade point average. Please join me in congratulating Lydia Aurora Bridges. So next, I have the further honor of introducing today's class of 22 valedictorian. This individual has achieved the highest GPA for her class over the past 4 years of high school, a 4.0. So today is about memories. Let me share one with you. A little over 13 years ago, that's right, 2008, this student started GGCA in kindergarten. That year, I met a family who came to America to step out in faith, seek opportunity, and to honor God. A husband and wife decided to leave their homeland and follow the call of the Lord to an unknown country. I'll be honest, when I was writing this introduction, I spent over a half hour trying to come up with an appropriate sentence to follow the communication of that decision. So here it is. That took faith, sacrifice, commitment, and all the challenges that come with a journey from Uzbekistan to the United States. So English is not your native language, and you're in an entirely new environment, learning school. This student had many challenges, but she overcame them all by never looking back and overcoming the obstacles by seeking and trusting God. Her smile is contagious, and one of her classmates remarked, "She is always seeking excellence and is consistent in her academic efforts. She says little, but when she speaks, her words are well thought through and wisdom is revealed. She is respected by every member of our class and truly represents a woman of humility." One of her coaches shared, "I felt her dedication, commitment, focus, and sacrificial efforts truly made the team grow together in Christ. You didn't realize how fast she was until the ball slipped past the defense and she was off to the races to net another goal for our team. Furthermore, she was a player who displayed integrity and demonstrated both a work ethic and positive mindset that always kept us in our games. In a cultural time in society that desperately needs truth, we are so thankful to be sending a person with convictions and character into the world who is willing to share their voice in reaching others with the gospel. As this student leaves our halls to pursue a college degree, there is no doubt of further success as God will be honored. Please join me in congratulating the GGCA Class of 22 valedictorian, Sharina Muradova."
Hi, everyone. Thank you all for coming out here today and joining us to celebrate the graduation of our class on this special day. Today marks the beginning of a new chapter of our lives and the end of yet another extraordinary one. It is my distinct honor to be standing up here before you. 13 years ago, when my family and I won the green card to come to the United States, we had absolutely no idea what our future would hold. We didn't know the language, the area, nor anyone else for that matter. However, when we arrived in Baltimore, Greater Grace welcomed us with open arms. Attending this incredible school and church has been one of the best things that has happened in my life. Being here, I've been surrounded by the best of friends, teachers, and classmates that I could have ever imagined. Looking back at my years at GGCA, I can honestly say that there's no better school that is filled with so many wonderful staff and faculty members who dedicate their time to the fulfillment of every student's individual goals. First and foremost, I would like to thank Pastor Barry for being a wise mentor and leader in our school. Thank you for teaching us and showing us what it means to be a follower of Christ. Your guidance has made this school flourish in many ways. To Mr. Shishmanian, I want to thank you for helping me throughout my college application process and for always encouraging me to do my best. Thank you for always being so invested in our lives. I would also like to thank all those who have taught us leadership this year. Thank you to Pastor Schaller for not only taking us to McDonald's across the street, but for teaching us the importance of having a personal relationship with Christ. Pastor Saraji, I want to thank you for teaching us how to defend our faith as we emerge from our life here at GGCA and make our way into the real world. Next, I want to thank all the teachers in elementary, middle school, and high school who have taught us and invested countless hours into our lives. Thank you for not only being our teacher in the classroom, but also our friend in time of need. We have learned so many valuable lessons under your guidance, and we are truly blessed to have been your students. Thank you for not only helping us grow mentally, but also spiritually. Thank you for giving me the ultimate gift of building a firm foundation and walk with Christ. I also want to thank Coach Lynch and all my other coaches who have been with us through the ups and downs of playing sports. Thank you for your sacrifice, your dedication, and volunteering your time to help us grow in athletics. You have taught us that playing sports is not only about winning, but first and foremost about glorifying God. So to my coaches, thank you. Next, I want to thank the two most important people in my life, my parents. I'm truly grateful for everything you have done for me. Dad, I want to thank you for working extremely hard over the years so my siblings and I could have a Greater Grace education. You have worked endless hours and even two or three jobs at one point. Your sacrifice and hard work hasn't gone unnoticed. Mom, I want to thank you for being the backbone of our family. If it wasn't for you, we would be a complete mess. Thank you for being my best friend and for always listening to what I have to say. Thank you both for the sacrifices that you've made and for all the love you've given me throughout my life. It is the result of your hard work and the values that you have instilled in me that has shaped me into the person I am today. There aren't enough words in the world to express my appreciation. I love you both forever. To my siblings, thank you for supporting me in everything I do and for always encouraging me to do my best. Although you guys do drive me crazy sometimes, I love you all. And happy birthday to my sister. So if you have a chance to wish her happy birthday, do so. Now to my fellow graduates, congrats. We have finally made it. It seems like yesterday we were bringing in toys for show and tell in Miss Anderson's classroom. We have come a long way. A few of us have been here for more than 12 years, while some became an addition to our class this year. However, no matter the amount of time we have spent together, we have become a family. I remember in middle school, we all hated each other, and our raging teenage hormones would constantly cause us to bicker and argue. However, over the last few years, we have bonded more than ever. We have spent countless hours studying for exams, encouraging each other when times got tough, and making memories that will last a lifetime. I will miss seeing your beautiful faces every morning, our random conversations during lunch, and especially laughing with Yana and Ryan and all of Mr. Cook's economics and American government classes. Mr. Cook, we promise we weren't laughing at you. I know we have been waiting for this moment for such a long time. So now, as we part ways, I want you to remember what we have learned about God's love, grace, forgiveness, and bind that to your hearts. I want to thank each and every one of you for always being there for me and for making my school days more enjoyable. You guys are amazing, and I have been blessed beyond measure by all of you. I know that God is going to bless and use each one of you in different ways. So congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Sharina. That was awesome. I have the privilege of giving out the athletic awards. We'll start with the most outstanding female athlete for class of 22. Tough-minded competitor is probably the word used by both coaches that coached her. Just her calm demeanor. And what I put in was Isaiah 30:15, her quietness and confidence was her strength. And that's what we saw not only in the classroom, but also on the field, the competition. Was an amazing player. She was a MIAC all-conference player in both volleyball and soccer for 2021 and also 2022. Big part of the conference soccer championship of our varsity girls in the 2021 finals. That was awesome. And volleyball coach, Coach Arian, I saw him back there. Good to see you. He said, I know her intent listening and attention to details is what made her succeed at multiple positions throughout the years. And I thought, wow, that being asked to be a defensive specialist, outside hitter, and to be able to play in the scheme of a team play takes attention to details. And to get that quote from a coach is pretty amazing. And the fact that her work ethic at practice from the soccer coach said was above excellent. Didn't matter the score, didn't matter. Practice, game, you got her best. And that's why we just saw that speech we just saw. Let's have a hand for Sharina Moldova. This young man played all three sports all 4 years, and the privilege of coaching him in all the sports, but also the privilege of watching him grow. Very fast, probably as fast as guys, as fast of a runner as we've had. You know, you can name them all down, the Tom Reagans, A.J. Lewis's, Ryan Heidenreich's. This guy was as fast, if not faster. But he improved. But the thing I liked the most is, as a captain, is that he could keep the team loose, he could keep the team focused, and he did that throughout. Whether he was a starter, whether he was on the bench, whether he was a sixth man, and I just was amazed that he was the same guy at practice, game, as a student, as he's done well in school here, as we saw also. But he anchored the defense. We had 9 shutouts this year, and that was, many of these guys were part of that season, okay? Made it to the state finals, and that was a total team effort. But I want to just give this guy a shout out, because teams would not want to go down the side he was on because of that speed and the coverage that he would do. Tenacity is probably the biggest word I would use for this young man. So let's have a hand for our most outstanding male athlete, True McCullough.
Can you all see me from here? I'm pretty short. Hi. So I had the privilege of doing the yearbook dedication speech. And so this year, for the yearbook dedication, the class of 2022 would like to thank and recognize the hard work and commitment that this teacher has put into our school, Mr. Jonathan Cook. Mr. Cook, our middle school and high school teacher, who has worked on the development of Greater Grace student life, both academically and spiritually, since his arrival from our sister school in Budapest, Hungary. He has worked tirelessly throughout the school year with the middle school and high school team competitions to inspire us to work together as a team and to bring school spirit to our school. Mr. Cook's willingness to interact with students has produced amazing results, such as the funny videos that he would make with all of us. His willingness to be a part of class retreats, chapel services, coaching sports, as well as helping the administration in many areas of the school has been remarkable. Along with Mr. Cook, we would also like to recognize his wife, Mrs. Christine Cook, our school secretary, and his mother, Mrs. Barbara Cook, who has worked very hard until the last minute on the yearbook while also teaching both middle school and high school. We'd like to thank you all for your hard work and commitment to our students.
Been trying to figure out what it means to be human, flesh and bone, the spirit and the soul. If I cannot earn your love by trying to measure up, why do I think I'd lose it in the lows? Somehow you see through my heart and you welcome me with open arms, just as I am, in the good, in the bad, you stay. wondering, always knowing what I need. With a gentle hand, you show me where to go. No, there hasn't been a moment you weren't calling out to me. I heard your voice and now I'm coming home. Just as I am, in the good and the bad, you still understand that you never stop loving me. Just as I am, with the heart of the Father and grace like no other, oh, you never stop loving me. Oh, just as I am. I just want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you for loving me. I just want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you for loving me. I just want to say thank you. My own silver screen painted sun never rain.
That was beautiful, wasn't it? Well, this is the moment you've been waiting for, seniors. The diplomas are on their way. So right now, we're going to ask you to rise and get prepared to receive your diplomas. We'll ask Mr. John Cook to read them for us.
Yana Ileana Andrews. Shamari Lucius Anthony. Evan Jeffrey Arsenal. Malva Michelle Siri Osk. Lydia Aurora Bridges. Ryan Nathan Horton. Lydia Kress. True Emmanuel McCullough. Mallory Teresa Mendoza Ramirez. Austin Christopher Mary. Yeah. Charles William Morales. Sharina Muradova. Lydine Princess Noble. Jung Hyun Shin. Vivian Marcella Vandever. Nicholas Yuri Wyman.
Okay, I think the charge has already been given. I think you guys got a great charge. Sharina said it well. We've said it to each other. But now it's my privilege to be able to present to these witnesses in attendance the graduates of the class of 2022. Please stand, face the audience, and turn those tassels. Give him a second.
If you would please stand with me, we will close in a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for this graduating class. Each individual here, bless them in their futures. Guide them, direct their steps. We ask that they always remember that they have a home here and they feel free to return. In all that they do, Lord, be with them. In your name. Amen.